been listening to the discussion back and forth, and there's nothing in this bill that reduces low-income families or middle-income families' taxes. Not even true. Where do we invest in people by taking from people, Mr. President? And while a lot of the discussion has been around the wealthiest of the wealthy, the problem is it doesn't just impact them, because we really don't. They say we know who those people are, but I'm going to look to my district. And we have a lot of people who maybe at one time or another were able to invest in another piece of property, not their primary residence, Mr. President. But they're good decisions that they made throughout their lives because they wanted to take responsibility for their retirement, for their needs as they age. You know, now could potentially be taken from them in this to pay, that they have to pay to the state government instead of taking care of themselves and their families. We know that there's tremendous need in the state, and we know that there are people who are going to need assistance as they age. They're going to need assistance with long-term care and the challenges that life presents us. Away from people potentially that are trying to do right by themselves and their families, and being prudent and doing that for themselves, Mr. President. So you're penalizing those that have done a good job and actually potentially made some money that they're putting towards retirement, towards, you know, long-term care. I can think of my own mother. You know, that's the income she's living on, Mr. President, and she's at that stage of her life where she may need to think about long-term care. So as we think about what we're doing and we think about that this is a tax on the super wealthy, whatever definition that is, you know, what it comes down to is you really bring more people into that, Mr. President. You can't help it because it's not defined. It's defined by income, but you don't know how you bring people unwittingly into that who have worked their entire lives just for that piece of a retirement fund that they can do right by themselves and take care of themselves. Instead of allowing the state to really function and take care of those who can't. So my point here, Mr. President, with this debate today, is we're unwittingly taking money from people who may unwittingly now need help from the government when they didn't need it before. And where's the equity in that? Where's the equity in that? You know, Just through World War I, income tax was expanded to the middle income tax. You know, during that to pay for World War I. It's not the way it started out. It started out as a wealthy tax. Connecticut, same thing. Now today, it's over half of the state's budget, Mr. President. And they indicated that they needed it to make that tax on middle income families because of the volatility, and they needed the money. New Jersey's another state done the same thing. And while today, yes, we are debating a tax on the wealthiest, on high income earners, that's not where this is going to go. And we all know when we do legislation in our chamber here and across the rotunda, that the hardest step of anything initially is the initial step. When it's passed and signed into law, it is so much easier to make it apply elsewhere. And I can guarantee you that it's a lot harder to fix the problems going forward because we don't do a very good job of that once any kind of legislation is instituted. You know, this is going to hurt the families who want to give to their kids. This is going to hurt people who are trying to do right by themselves and prepare for their future throughout their life. And I don't think it's right for the state of Washington to take that from them. I'm proud of the work that we have done to help people who need it, and we will continue to do that in the state of Washington without this bill. Vote this down.